Welcome back, everyone. February is Black History Month, and to honor the struggle, we're spotlighting a powerful new show that centers on a haunting case that sparked the civil rights movement in America. Benevolence world premiere is tomorrow in St. Paul. And here to tell us more, we have Talvin Wilkins, the show's director, and Sarah Bellamy, the artistic director of the Penumbra Theater. Thank you both for being here with us today. So we know this year the national theme for Black History Month is migration. Talk a little bit about how this play will tie into that theme.
Well, I think for me, and I'd be interested in what you have to mm-hmm. say, Talvin, but I think for me, you know, this play is really looking at a critical moment in our nation's history, the death of Emmett Till, his murder. And I think the spate of violence that happened after that encouraged quite a few people to leave the South and try to migrate north. To escape the violence that was really clamping down at that moment.
But I think it also connects to sort of cultural history and sort of anti-immigrant sentiment, connected to anti-Black sentiment, sort of what is at the core source of those particular attitudes in our society. And so this is the history in the South where African Americans are terrorized and, you know, have to sort of migrate north to sort of escape that history.
Yeah, I know my family migrated north from the South. The world premiere is tomorrow night. What can folks expect?
Well, I think some people who know about the trilogy and may know about Ballad of Emmett Till that we did in 2014, this is sort of what I call the second installment, but it really deals with the ripple effects of the everyday culture that could create such an event that murdered Emmett Till. Mm-hmm.
And when we say Emmett Till, for our viewers who may not know, who was Emmett Till? We know those images of him really changed people's thoughts.
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, Emmett Till, more than anything, I think what's important for us to remember, he's a little boy, he was 14 years old, just turned, who traveled to Money, Mississippi to visit family down there from Chicago.
A Black boy.
Black boy who was accused of whistling at a white woman, Carolyn Bryant, who later in life, in 2016, was it?
Right.
Admitted that she had made the entire story up. And this boy subsequently was murdered very brutally by her husband and his brother.
And it also comes out in the play, which is very important, in her actual testimony, it's more than a whistle. She actually accuses him of assaulting her. And so most people don't know that aspect of the story. They reduce it down to that sort of that bit of information. So that's why I feel the play is so important, because it really gives sort of a greater depth to the events that occurred.
And we're looking at some pictures from the play, which, as you guys mentioned, will take us to the town of Mississippi and explore what happened. Emmett Till still has a place in Black history today.
It's still significant because, of course, you think of Trayvon Martin, you think of all the subsequent killings today, and there's a reason why we make that conflation. Emmett went to buy some bubble gum. Trayvon Martin is carrying Skittles. And there's this notion that these boys are denied their adolescence, their childhood, and they're considered, you know, they're accused of being, you know, men, and yet they're young boys.
All right. Well, thank you both for being here. We know Penumbra has a great presence in our community and is definitely needed. If you would like to see the world premiere, it's happening tomorrow at 7:30 at Penumbra Theater in St. Paul. The production runs through March 10th. For showtimes and tickets, call Penumbra's box office at 651-224-3180. We will put all of this information on our 11 a.m. show page on care11.com.